Hi, I'm Amanda Cavallaro, a developer advocate at Vonage, and today I'll show you how to create an SMS message log, a response to the sender using Cloud Functions, Firebase Real-Time Database, and the Vonage SMS API. To complete this tutorial, you need a Firebase and a Vonage account, so make sure you have these at hand before we get started. Create a new project from the Firebase console and give it a name. Click Continue. Choose if you will use Analytics for this project and click to create the project. You then wait for a bit for it to be created. Click on the gear icon and then Usage and Billings. Click on Details and Settings and click to modify the plan. We're going to choose Blaze for this project. Then choose to purchase, close it, click on the gear again, select Project Settings, and then on the default GCP resources, choose the resources that best serve you. From your terminal, install the Firebase tools with npm by typing npm install -g firebase-tools. Then you log in to Firebase by typing Firebase login. The login process will open your browser for authentication. Once it's complete, it's time for us to create the project folder, change directory inside of it, and then open it in your favorite text editor or IDE. Initialize Cloud Functions for Firebase by typing Firebase init functions. Since you've already created the project in the Firebase dashboard, you can select Use an existing project. It will prompt you to choose the desired project. Select the project name you created. You then select JavaScript for the programming language, and then choose if you will use ESLint. Now you can install all the dependencies. These steps will create the folders and files required to build Firebase functions. Once npm completes, switch to the functions directory by typing cd functions, and then open index.js in your editor to do the coding part. Delete all the boilerplate code from index.js. At the start of the file, add the following code to use the Firebase functions and Firebase admin. We then initialize the Firebase app that holds the information for a collection of services. Let's create the inbound SMS method using the Firebase function boilerplate. It will add the incoming SMS messages to the Firebase real-time database. The inbound endpoint listens for HTTPS requests, which is precisely what the Vonage webhook expects. The Firebase function will capture the request.body if we're using POST or the request.query if we're using GET. And then it sends the message queue object in the real-time database as a log, and finally it sends a status 200 for success. It is time to deploy our first function created by deploying it to Firebase. So type Firebase deploy dash dash only functions. The vital piece from the output is the function URL, in our case the inbound SMS. This URL is required to set up the webhook in Vonage. Log into your Vonage account, click on Settings. Vonage has two APIs which are capable of sending SMS. For today's project, we're going to use the SMS API. We can use GET or POST. I am going to use POST. Once I paste the inbound SMS webhook that I previously copied from the output, I click to save changes. On the menu on the left, you can click on Numbers and Buy Numbers to buy a Vonage virtual phone number. If you grab your phone and send a text message to the number you just purchased, you can see all the information on the real-time database. To work on our second function, we're going to need two more dependencies to our list. The first one is the .env, followed by the Vonage Server SDK 1. create a .env file and add the environment variables in the functions directory. The two of them we're going to need are the Vonage API key and the Vonage API secret. Both can be found from the Vonage API dashboard. At the top of our index.js file, we are going to require and configure .env. Followed by that, we require the Vonage Server SDK dependency. And after that, we're going to start a Vonage object that we're going to pass the two environment variables that we have in our .env file. Now you can create the new function for Firebase to send the response. Firebase functions can react to database updates. When a new entry is added, the code sends an echo of the original text. The new function will watch for the new messages added to the message queue database object. When triggered, the full Vonage object gets passed as a message. This object includes MSISDN, which is the originating phone number, yours in this case, and the to number, which is the Vonage virtual number you purchased. We're also adding a message saying you sent the following text and the text which was inside the message you sent from your phone number. In case there aren't any errors, the message is going to be echoed back. We're also adding one more piece of code called result to our Firebase real-time database. Deploy the Firebase functions again from the command line. And to test our echo workflow is working, let's try sending a message which should be logged by our first function to the message queue, and upon creation picked up by our send message method. You have now completed all the steps for this tutorial. You can see the full code on GitHub.